Hi, I'm Gary Eckstein from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner. In this tutorial, I'm going to go through how we can authenticate our domain that we send emails from in Mailchimp, how we can authenticate that domain in SiteGround. So if you use SiteGround for your web hosting and you use Mailchimp to send email marketing, then this is the tutorial for you. I've done tutorials in the past on how to authenticate your domain in Bluehost, GoDaddy, cPanel, and so on, and they've been very popular, so I hope that this will help you if you do use SiteGround. We'll go across to Mailchimp. The advantage of authenticating our domain in Mailchimp is that when we send from that domain, send email marketing from that domain, from Mailchimp, there's less chance that the emails will go into the spam folder or will go into the promotions folder in Gmail. So that's why it's worthwhile authenticating your domain. In Mailchimp, to see our domains that we can send from, the easiest way really is to click website to the left-hand side of the screen and then click domains. This is my demo account, and you can see that these three domains are domains that I can send from in Mailchimp. In other words, Gary at garysclass.com, Gary at organicweb.com.au, and so on. If you want to add a new domain you might have purchased to Mailchimp to be able to send from that email in Mailchimp, you quite simply click Verify Email, enter your email address into that field. Click Send Verification Email. Mailchimp will send you an email which you can just click on. You'll then be able to send from that domain, your name at domain name, from Mailchimp. Some of those emails may, however, get into spam, go to the spam folder, the junk folder. So what we want to do is we want to get to authenticated. We want to authenticate our domain. So when you first add your domain in Mailchimp, you'll have blue verified to the right. We want to get to green authenticated. To get to green authenticated, if you use SiteGround, we need to add what are called some CNAME records or domain records to SiteGround. So I'm going to be going backwards and forwards a little bit, but it'll make sense. So first off, let's go to SiteGround. I'm in SiteGround. We want to click Site Tools for the domain that you've added to Mailchimp that you want to authenticate. So once this loads up, we click on Domain to the left-hand side of the screen. You then need to click DNS Zone Editor. So I click DNS Zone Editor. And our various records appear, but don't worry too much what's showing at the moment. What we're wanting to do is add some CNAME records. So if I just click on CNAME under Create New Record, if I click CNAME, you'll see there's various details needed. Let's go back to Mailchimp. To get those records we need to add, we click Authenticate to the right-hand side of the screen next to the domain that or to which you're amending records in SiteGround. So I click Authenticate. There's a bit of stuff going on here, but Mailchimp is basically saying create two records, two CNAME records. What I do here, if you use SiteGround, is copy this first part before your domain name. So in other words, here it would be k2.domainkey. So copy that bit, copy it, come back to SiteGround, and merely paste it in the field. There we go. Go back to Mailchimp, copy that little bit underneath, so dkim2.mcsv.net, just copy that, and in the resolves 2, we'll just paste it into there. Don't worry about TTL or time to live, that's fine. We click Create. Going back to Mailchimp, Mailchimp said, look, you need to also create two records. So we've done the K2, so let's do the K3. So again, we copy that bit before the dot and your domain name. So K3 dot underscore domain key, copy that bit, come back to SiteGround, and I'll just click back because we've already created that CNAME record. So we're still under CNAME, under Create New Record, still CNAME. So I'll just paste that information into there. Come back to Mailchimp. So it's a bit of going backwards and forwards. Now copy this DKIM3, etc. Just copy that. Come back. Paste it in. Click Create. And there we go. I'm just going to click back. So what we've done now is we added these two CNAME records, and you can see them there. And these will propagate around the web, and it can take a little while for them to propagate. Let's go back to Mailchimp. I click Authenticate Domain, and Mailchimp now goes and checks that we've actually added those records. As you can see here, Mailchimp says it can take 24 to 48 hours, and Mailchimp will just keep checking and authenticate it. I'll just click cancel for now. So you can go away and do what you want to. If after 48 hours, you aren't seeing green authenticated next to your domain, again, just click authenticate again and authenticate domain, and Mailchimp will go and check once more. Thanks for joining me. And this is the way we authenticate our domain. So less emails will go to the spam folder and the Gmail promotions folder for your subscribers, if you use SiteGround, that is. Thanks for joining me. My name's Gary Eckstein from organicweb.com.au.